Well, hi friends, this is Sandeep Mahajan. I'm from Excelsior Academy Amritsar, and in this particular video I'm going to talk about IELTS writing task 1, especially the bar graph. I'm going to explain the bar graph and I will give you the vocab and how you can use the vocab to explain that particular bar graph so that you can score well in your IELTS exam. Thank you. Well, friends, after the brief introduction of our company, now let's talk about IELTS writing task 1 bar graph. Basically, in IELTS writing task 1, this is one of the tasks which is given to the students to explain. Now, this is the bar graph where we have taken on x-axis different countries. We have taken like US, Canada, UK, Australia, New Zealand, Cyprus and Poland. And what this bar graph is telling is basically the number of students, that is Indian students, who are going to different countries for higher education. And the data is taken of year 2000, right? Now let's see, and on this side we have taken the number, and the numbers are in 1000. Basically, if you see the three zeros are there, that three zeros means you have to attach three zeros after 10, and if you attach three zeros after 10, then it will come down to 10,000. Similarly, 20,000, 30,000 and 40,000 and so on. And as I have already told you that we are basically from Excelsior Academy Amritsar. We also pronounce our company as Excelsior Academy of IELTS and Immigration Company. You can meet us in Amritsar. Now let's talk about this bar graph again and how to explain it. Yes, this is the vocab. We have given you a brief vocab where we have provided you with the different phrases and different words which you can use to explain this particular graph, and definitely these words and phrases will help you out. You can take a printout of this vocab and you can use later on while explaining the graph. Now let's come to the graph again and we will explain you the vocab which we had shown you in our previous slide, this vocab, and we will explain you one by one how these different phrases and words can be used to explain the bar graph, right? Let's go to the next slide, and we are going to take now first of all more than, greater than and higher than, how to explain these phrases. And for that we are going to, I am going to explain you that with the help of a sentence, and the sentence is this. Let's say now, for example, we are to explain about this, that the number of Indian students going to Canada, like we come down to Canada, this is the Canada. Now number of Indian students going to Canada was more than, right, greater than or higher than the number of students who opted Australia. That if we are comparing Canada and Australia, definitely the number of students who are going to Canada are more than, right? And we can use another phrase, is greater than or higher than. This is the way how can we use this phrase and how can we explain this particular point. Let's see the other one. Yes, one more thing, than is basically used to compare two things, right? And if, instead of than, you can use the phrase as compared to or in comparison with. Let's see how we can use this. That in this particular sentence, if you see now, we can say the same. The number of Indian students going to Canada was, now instead of than, we can use in comparison with. The number of students going to Canada was more in comparison with the number of students who opted Australia, right? So this situation you have explained with the help of more than, greater than and higher than. Let's go for the next phrase, that is less than, lower than and fewer than. In case of less than, lower than and fewer than, how to use? Let's take the sentence. The number of Indian students going to New Zealand. Now we have taken this particular point, New Zealand. If you see that 60,000 students are going to New Zealand, this is how you can see, meet this point with the on this side, and this is the figure which is equivalent to New Zealand. So 60,000 students are going to New Zealand. Now it sees that the number of Indian students going to New Zealand was less than the number of students who opted Australia and Canada. Definitely, so if you see Canada, 80,000 students are going, and in case of you can say this particular country which is Australia, it is little less than 80,000, around 77,000 students, which are definitely, in case if we see New Zealand, so definitely the number of students going to New Zealand are less than these two country. So this is how you can use these particular phrases. Now let's come with the other phrases. Now the other phrases which we are going to explain are maximum, highest, peak, top, means the maximum number of students. Now how you can explain this? If we say the maximum are going to this country, that is Canada. So we can explain this particular point again in this way also, that the maximum or highest or peak number of Indian students selected Canada as their destination for higher education, right? So you can use these phrases in this way also, or in other words, you can explain this point in this way also. Then let's see another one, that is minimum, lowest and least. So if you say the least one are over here in case of Cyprus, right? You can use the sentence also that the minimum number of Indian students went to Cyprus for further education, right? So you can use the word lowest also, least also, that the least number of Indian students went to Cyprus for further education, right? Or let's say go for the another phrase, that is the most demanded. Yes, these phrases are very good, and if you use these phrases properly, you will definitely score good bands. The most demanded, popular, sorted out, liked, preferred and opted. Let's see how to use these phrases or words. Like for example, now Canada was of course the most demanded, right? If you see the most demanded or preferred countries, what? Canada. You can say, you can explain it in this way, Canada was the most demanded, or Canada was the most popular or sorted out or liked or preferred and opted country among Indian students as the destination for higher education. Let's see for the another phrase. Another is the least demanded. The words like popular, phrase sorted out, liked, preferred, opted, and how to use these phrases in sentences. Like for example, the least one was Cyprus. So Cyprus was the least demanded, or you can say Cyprus was the least popular, Cyprus was the least sorted out, liked or preferred country as only 10,000 students. You say Cyprus is touching somewhat over here, as approximately 10,000 students you can say landed there for higher education. This is how you can use these kind of phrases, and definitely you should use these phrases to score more. Let's go for the next phrase or words. Now the next words are like double, and phrases like three times, three folds, many folds, and how you can use them. If we say USA, okay, where is the USA? USA, if you see, there are 20,000 students who are going to USA, and it has been compared with Cyprus. If you say Cyprus, 10,000 approximately, then what we say is that USA extracted exactly double the number of Indian students in comparison with Cyprus, which was demanded by only 10,000 Indian students. If you multiply 10,000 with 2, so definitely it will come to 20,000. So USA means, let's say we can say, in another word, we can say that 20,000 or double the number of students prefer to go to USA as compared to Cyprus. Let's go for the next one. One half. Yes, three times. Yes, in case of three times, if it is three times, let's say 60, for example, 60,000 students are going to New Zealand, whereas 20,000 are going to USA. Then you can say that the number of students going to New Zealand are three times as compared to the number of students who are going to USA. Now this is three times, 20 multiplied by 3, which comes to 60. So 60,000 students are three times. Now to talk about half, one third or one fourth. Half means exactly half. If we say USA, 20,000 students are going to USA and 10,000 to Cyprus or Poland, then it is almost half as compared to this particular USA. Let's explain it with the help of a sentence. Like for example, we have taken the example of one third, right? The number of Indian students who selected USA, of course 20,000, was one third as in comparison with the number of students who reached New Zealand. Now 60,000 students reached New Zealand and 20,000 in USA, and this is how 20,000 divided by 60,000 come to 1/3. So that is why we have used the phrase 1/3. The number of Indian students who selected USA was 1/3 in comparison with the number of students who reached New Zealand for higher education. This is how you can use this particular phrase, right? Then next we are going to talk about slightly over, little over, around, about, approximately, or slightly less, little less, around, about, approximately. Let's see how to use these phrases. Like for example, UK attracted little over, you can say slightly over 20,000 students, Indian students, to continue their studies. Like 20,000 UK, we are now talking about UK. Now UK, if you say it is over 20,000, so it's, if it is slightly over, little over, we can say if it is, let's, it should be like this. So little over students who basically decided to go to what is called UK, right? If this you say, this is not exactly 10,000. Poland is exactly 10,000. It is little less than 10,000. So for this particular country, Cyprus, we can say the number of Indian students who prefer to go to Cyprus were slightly less or little less than 10,000, or can you can simply use were approximately 10,000 students who were going to particular this particular country. So this is how you can use little, slightly over, little over, slightly less, little less, or approximately, right? Now next is equal, same, or similar. Right, so how to use this particular phrase? If you say Cyprus and Poland, they're somewhat, I won't say that they are exactly equal, but yes, they are somewhat equal. So we can say that Cyprus and Poland were the choice of almost equal number of Indian students. You can say Cyprus and Poland were almost choice of equal or same or similar number of Indian students. Let's talk about the next, respectively. Yes, respectively we used to explain large amount of data. When there is large amount of data, then we can use this word respectively, which helps us explain the large amount of data in one single sentence. Let's see how. Now, if we are to explain the data for Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Poland in one single sentence, then we can say that the number of Indian students who selected Canada, Australia, New Zealand and Poland, Canada, Australia, New Zealand and Poland were 80,000, 77,000 Australia, 60,000 New Zealand and 11,000 basically we have used for Poland, approximately little over 10,000. Respectively. Here as respectively means that the first figure goes for the first country, the second figure is related to the second country, the third figure is related to the third country. So that is where you can use the word respectively, where you can use it to explain large amount of data. Then comes closely follows or closely followed. Just I'm going to explain it. Try to listen very carefully. This is a good one if you can use it properly. Like Australia, if you see Australia, right? Closely followed Canada. Australia is closely following Canada in case of Indian students who entered these countries for their further education, right? Australia closely follows, we have used the phrase Australia closely follows Canada. Now closely followed, if in case closely follows, we are using the country with the lower figure first and lower figure first and the country with the higher figure later. And in case of this particular phrase, if it has been explained, yes, it has been explained, Canada is closely followed by Australia. Now we are taking the higher figure before, earlier, and the lower figure later. Now Canada is closely followed by Australia in case of number of Indian students who landed up in these countries for higher education. So use these phrases very carefully, right? Now let's go for the next one. The next one is, yes, of course, conclusion, which is very important. You can use like in this particular line, in conclusion, or you can use this phrase to sum up. It can be deduced or interpreted or inferred or concluded from the graph that And after that, you can give your conclusion. Like, for example, conclusion one is given in this way. Like, finally, we have used, taken this particular word. Finally, it can be deduced from the graph that Canada, Australia, and New Zealand were the preferred countries among Indian students for further studies. Just see the striking factor of, in conclusion, you are not to give the data. Basically, you are to give this striking feature of the graph. Now, the striking feature of the graph is that these three are the most preferred. These three are the favorite countries among the Indian students. So we have explained it can be deduced. You are not so say simply that the maximum number of students goes to this country and the minimum goes to this country. You can make it a better, you can give a better solution like this or better conclusion like this, that Canada, Australia and New Zealand were the preferred countries among the Indian students for their this further education, whereas Cyprus, Poland were the least favorite among them, whereas the Cyprus and the Poland were the least or less favorite countries among Indian students. The another way, if you see that, another way also we can give the conclusion that in, to sum up, it can be preferred, it can be inferred from the graph that Indian students liked to go to different countries. Indian students, of course, like to go to different countries for their further education, but Canada and Australia were the most popular countries among them, whereas the lowest number of students liked Cyprus. Means you can give solution or conclusion in n number of ways, but I would recommend those, don't give solution simply this is the highest figure or this is the lowest figure. Just try to give a more, or you can say a better conclusion, a better means in a better way, so that you can score good points. So this was, I think, the bar graph. This is how you could explain the bar graph. Thank you very much for watching the video. Yes, I would request you to, if you have liked the video, if you are able to understand the graph, do like this video and do share this videos with your friends who are basically going to appear in IELTS in near future, right? And of course, subscribe our channel, our YouTube channel, which is with the name, our channel is Excelsior Academy Amritsar. It is with the name Excelsior Academy Amritsar. Do subscribe it and you will be able to watch more videos on different graphs. If you want to watch the video in Hindi or Punjabi language, or a mixture of Hindi or Punjabi, Hindi and English, or Punjabi and English, so those kind of videos are also there for better understanding for the people who are from India, Pakistan, and Nepal, right? And if you wish, these are our phone numbers. If you are in Amritsar and want to join our academy, you are definitely requested to call and meet us. And this is our full address. If you say we are based at Vijayanagar, Amritsar, this is exactly the full address. And if you want to write us about, I would like if you can give us your feedback, you can send us a mail of your feedback at this particular email ID. Thank you very much once again for watching the video and have a good day. And all the best to you if you are going to appear in your IELTS exam in near future. I hope and I wish that you all score very good. Thank you.